Grabe ng braso ko, ha? Malaki.
Drink it like it's a commercial.
Ay, grabe ng modeling.
Okay.
How do I do this?
Okay. No, not like that.
Bongga ng beauty dito, ha? Dito si Pia!
Hi, guys! Kumusta?
Hi! Guys, hi, my name is PatrickStarrr, and welcome back to my channel. Today, I have a very special guest, Pia Miss Universe!
Hi, guys! And we're at Miss Universe. I'm gonna be a judge tonight.
I'm so excited.
I'm excited.
Lady in red. We went for a red lip. We have hair slate by Glam Tech Steven T. A full beat face on my one and only Pia. I'm so honored. She slid in the DMs. We are here at Miss Universe at Planet Hollywood. I set up Star Studios up in my hotel room, and she was so more than happy to come on my channel.
Of course.
We're so, so excited. If you guys want to see how we did this beautiful slate beat bonga look, then keep on watching. And don't forget to subscribe. You know how to say it in Tagalog, subscribe?
Huwag niyo kalimutan mag-subscribe, mga mamshi.
Mamshi. Masarap ng mukha mo, ha?
Oh my God! I should be saying oh my God.
Oh my... Magandang hapon na!
Hi, guys!
Oh my gosh! We are here with Pia and PatrickStarrr. Peace, go wear it up in the house. We are here to paint you for Miss Universe.
I know.
You are judging.
Yes, I'm judging this year's Miss Universe pageant. And I have Patrick here to make me look like a Miss Universe.
Girl, you are Miss Universe. You is Miss Universe. You eat Miss Universe. You breathe, sleep, and live Miss Universe. Guys, what an honor. I am ready to be her face. She's wearing red. And we are going to snatch and beat her face. We have Steven on her hair. Is you ready?
I'm ready. Let's do it.
Oh, let's do it. Let's do it. First, I have Pia priming her face with this Marc Jacobs primer. Priming is a must, correct?
Correct.
Correct. And you know, she has YouTube videos too. I was watching them too. She's just coming from my YouTube.
Oh my gosh, video, now I'm girl. Embarrassed. Did I do okay?
Yes. You know, for Miss Universe, tell them you have to do your makeup.
Yeah,
everything.
You have to know how to do your own makeup if you want to join a beauty pageant, because not every day there's going to be a makeup artist there. So it's a big plus if you can do your own.
And so she was telling me she was practicing and practicing. So when you did Miss Universe, when you won, you did your makeup at what time?
I did it at 5 a.m. The competition was 4 p.m.
She was beating her face for nearly 11 hours before she actually did it. And you know what? If that's the trick, do your makeup for 11 hours. All right, so for our foundation, I'm going to go ahead with this Makeup Forever and mix it with a little bit of Giorgio Armani Luminous Silk. And I'm using the color number 8 and Makeup Forever number Y405. And we're here in Las Vegas.
Yeah, back in Vegas, every corner of this hotel reminds me of Miss Universe.
And now you're judging.
And so now I'm judging.
How does it feel to come back to be a judge? Tell the kids.
You know, I feel like being a judge is more difficult than being a Miss Universe. Because it's in your hands, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Somebody's life is gonna change tonight. And I know what it feels like to be up there. I'm also nervous for them. Whenever I see the girls on Instagram, I just keep thinking, oh my gosh, like, I know what it feels like to do your last rehearsal, dress rehearsals, being backstage, all the hair and makeup that's going on at the same time, all the 92 girls competing this year. Can I tell everyone how we met?
I was just about to say yes.
So, I think only a week ago, right? Just
yes.
About a week ago, I was with my best friend Harley, and we were watching your makeup tutorials mm-hmm. on YouTube, and we were, you know, just in bed. We were being lazy that day. Mm-hmm. We were just watching, and we did a marathon of, I think, almost all of your videos.
No way.
Just the whole afternoon.
What was the first one you clicked on?
The first one was Kim Kardashian.
Oh, Miss Kim. Yeah. Oh, my best friend.
That was the first one. YouTube just started playing all of your mm-hmm. stuff, so we're just like, and then I was supposed to start getting ready for work, but I just couldn't move, and I was thinking, my gosh, like, I can't believe I'm really sitting through all of this and watching all this makeup, but it's so good. Like, and you know what, that day I was like, you know what, I'm gonna do my makeup today, like, real good, because mm-hmm. I got inspired.
No way.
I was like, I miss doing like a full face mm-hmm. on my own. So I said, you know what, Harley, I'm gonna go do my makeup now inside, because this, all these videos are like...
And then you guys found out that I was Filipino.
Yeah, because in one of your videos, you mentioned that you were Filipino, mm-hmm. and then that I was thinking, oh my gosh, Harley, he's Filipino, and he does makeup. I hope he's based in LA, or I'm mm-hmm. assuming you are. Mm-hmm. And then I searched you on Instagram.
Girl.
And then I saw that you were in fact Filipino, and that you were following me.
Yes.
So I said, oh my gosh, so if I DM him, he'll see it right away. So because I had been trying to jump in
on your live streams. You know, she live streams, you know, she'll live stream eating, and she'll live stream like horse races, whatever, wherever she's doing at a party. Every single time I would try to jump in and be like, Pia, I want to do your makeup. And she's so famous, you guys. She, like, follow her on social media. She kills it. She is like top model, Asia, world, universe. It's so, so good. And I was like, oh my God, she's never going to see me. And she slid in my DM.
I
was shook. I was like, Pear! Actually, if you guys don't know, we're not in LA right now. I brought my whole setup here mm-hmm. to Las Vegas, here at the Planet Hollywood Hotel, and set it up right next to my bed. There's the bathroom right there. We're here mm-hmm. live, and it's just so, so crazy.
Thank you for doing
this. No, I had to. I was like, this is like Filipino pride right here, exploding with beauty, and I'm so, so excited to have you.
Oh, thank you so much. I can't believe it, but I'm actually here. Yes. I'm the one who should be fangirling.
Oh my gosh, no.
I feel like I find everyone on Instagram.
Yes, everyone.
I found my boyfriend on Instagram.
Oh, do you care to share a trick or two?
Yes.
What? Oh, you know.
No, I just started liking a few pictures first, just mm-hmm. to kind of knock mm-hmm. on the door.
Mm-hmm.
Like, let him know I'm here.
Mm-hmm.
This was while I was Miss Universe. I've always had a crush on this guy.
Oh, she said, I have a crown and I have a goal.
Yeah.
And you're a goal. You're very much a go-getter.
Yes, yes.
And
so I had a crush on him like a few years ago, but then at that time, I kept on losing at Miss Philippines, uh-huh. and I was thinking, he's never going to notice
me. And for the kids
that
don't know you, you competed for Miss Philippines how many times?
I competed 3 times in the Philippines until I eventually won the 3rd time. And then I went on to Miss Universe, and then I won Miss Universe in the most interesting way, mm-hmm. if you guys remember.
You guys, I'm sure y'all remember Mr. Steve. He is here tonight.
No, he's back.
He's back. Also.
Anyway, so I was thinking, oh, he's never going to
And this was after you won.
And then after I won, for some reason, like, I was on Instagram and I was like, wonder where Marlon is now, like, mm-hmm. whatever happened to him. And then I looked for him on Instagram and I saw that he was single.
She's like, I'm single.
And then I followed him and I liked a few pictures. And he was online at the same time, so he saw my...
You have special access to that? Like, you can see who's online?
No, he told me that he was online when I started liking the photos, and that's why he knew about it, and then he noticed it, and then...
Was he following you?
He wasn't.
Ugh!
He didn't even know who I was, which is good. Which is good, actually.
How dare you?
He didn't know. He knew that Philippines won at Miss Universe, but he didn't know that it was me. Mm-hmm. So he had through like scroll through my
your winning and your crowning.
Yeah.
And
he had to look for it and be like, oh, it's really her.
Gosh, she told me when she won, all the Ubers in the Philippines had little crowns on them.
Yeah, it was
Filipino
really cute.
Pride. So mm-hmm. cute. What is a must when it comes to like Miss Universe makeup? Like, what is your must? What is your go-to?
Well, it has to be good for stage mm-hmm. and good for an HD camera. Too, mm-hmm. because the cameras nowadays are all HD. Mm-hmm. They see everything. They see all the imperfections. Mm-hmm. So your makeup has to be perfect. What I noticed that some girls do, like mm-hmm. some mistakes I noticed, they don't know when to put the brush down. Mm-hmm. Like they don't know when to stop.
It and you said you cold. Learned that mistake. You were telling me earlier.
Yeah.
On your, what is it, the third time you did Miss Philippines, mm-hmm. you said your mistakes were... Lashes.
That?
She stacked her lashes, guys. She was PatrickStarrr back in the day. Oh my gosh. See, I know a queen when I see one. Yes.
I would do two lashes, stack them on top of each other, and then I would cut up.
Who taught you that trick?
I just learned it from some of the girls in the Philippines.
Oh, the girls. Yeah. Drag queens sa Pilipinas, huh?
Yeah, the girls.
And you had bottom lashes too.
Yeah, I would cut them up and then just put them on the bottom lash. Mm. She better work.
Yes. That's a pink. And then I have a, you know, Ruby Woo from MAC?
Yeah.
I have a Patrick Woo.
Ooh. Patrick Woo. Yes. Ooh.
And there's a Patrick Woo gloss. This is the MAC Studio Finish Concealer in the color NW25, which I use under her eyes. She has a little bit of a spray tint and she's wearing a beautiful red dress. Mm-hmm. And so next, I'm going to take the Precisely Mad Brow by Benefit in the shade number 4 and feather some strokes into her brows. Can you tell some other beauty secrets? Any hacks? Mm. Pageant hacks. Anything.
Do you ever hear about using hairspray for the legs, for the butt, for the tummy. It helps it not jiggle when you walk in a swimsuit.
Can you get me a can of hairspray? I need to spray my belly right now. She was trying to tell me something. She's like, you know,
no.
we need a hairspray this arm back here.
Oh, to get used to smiling for hours, mm-hmm. what I used to do is I take a pen or whatever I can find.
Really?
And then when I'm driving, for example, if it takes me 45 minutes to get to training, and I'm just like...
Oh my god, you're so good.
Yeah.
The powder that I'm using on Pia is the Patrick's Powder by MAC. Oh my god, I'm so excited that I get to use it finally on somebody. It's been a long, long secret. So this is a beautiful setting powder. I'm just gonna bake the center because she gets oily and she's doing the red carpet. And then I want her to glow, so I'll leave the outside blank. All right, guys, since my beauty queen is a go-getter, we are taking the PatrickStarrr and MAC palette called Go-Getter, and we are gonna take a little bit of soft brown and run this through the crease. And I'm using this brush by Morphe, the M441.
Mm-hmm. They're like super hope bronze. MAC in the Philippines are gonna give me some.
Girl, you have PatrickStarrr. I will give you some today. All right, guys. Next, we're gonna take the Glam AF palette, and I created this color called Omage because it's such a cute color. It's called Omage.
Really?
Yes. Omage.
Omage.
Yes. I'm just gonna take Omage on a flat brush and just apply it on the eye as a spotlight, because she's gonna be in the spotlight tonight.
You know, I need to teach you some gay lingo, na Filipino, na Tagalog. Okay. Okay, do you know any? Have you heard of Gandara?
Gandara, ano yan?
Ganda. Yeah, just sometimes you just make it longer.
So when you come out tonight, Gandara?
Pak, ganun.
Pak?
Pak.
Pak?
Pak. Yung ganun, you know the word ganun.
Ganun.
It's spelled differently now. It's G-A-N-E-R-N. Ganern. Pak ganern.
Pak ganern.
Yeah. Mm. So if you see like a girl, you know, walking in a beautiful gown, you're Star. Like, or you, mm-hmm. I'll be like, Pak ganern.
Oh, wow.
Ganern.
Include ng snap.
Yeah.
Okay. What else?
My gosh, the things I'm teaching you. You know bonga, right?
Bonga.
Bonga.
My mama says that all the time.
Mamshi. Do you know mamshi?
Mamshi.
So, mamshi. It's like sister.
Mamshi.
Mamshi. Hi, mom.
Mamshi. I love this liner. This is by MAC. This is called Brush Black. And we're going to go so close to the lash line and then do a thin liner. Next, I'm gonna take a pencil crayon and line underneath. You cannot have false lashes without tight lining.
Your Tagalog's really good, really? Considering that you haven't been home in a while. Mm-hmm.
What's your biggest advice to girls that are like probably too nervous to try a pageant or...
Oh my God, I was nervous too. I guess you just kind of have to go for it. It's normal to feel nervous or scared. It's part of the process, but you will grow so much after, trust me.
So for the under eyes, we're gonna take Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Finish Powder and dust it under the eyes before I go ahead and smoke at the bottom. This just adds light. It's one of my favorite powders for television, filming HD. It just gives it that perfect look. And then we're gonna go ahead and brush number 3. Next from the Grant My F palette, we're gonna take a little bit of Saddle and start the transition on the outer corner of the lash line. Next, I'm gonna take Embark and run this closer to the lash line to give it some depth. So next for blush, we're gonna take MAC Peaches, one of my favorite blushes ever. Tell us why, how many dresses you went through for when you won. Was it the first dress? Was it like 50 dresses?
Before I decided on the blue one?
Yeah, on the blue.
Oh, it was the blue one. Initially, my national director did not want me to wear gowns that were made by a Filipino designer.
Mm.
He preferred her taste. Oh, she preferred her taste, sorry. Mm-hmm. And for years, it was like that for Miss Philippines. And the thing is, we would always wear, because she's Colombian, our national director is Colombian, and she would, and then we weren't allowed to wear Filipino designers, and our gowns would always be made by a Colombian designer instead. So usually what happens if you're Miss Philippines, you arrive at Miss Universe, you look for Miss Colombia, and she has your gown, because she has her gown with her and Miss Philippines' gown, because it's usually made by the same designer.
Mm-hmm.
So, good thing for my year that I didn't have to look for Miss Colombia to look for my gown.
Because
I was able to convince Madame, which is the national director, I was able to convince her to please, please let me wear the color that I want from the designer that I want.
Mm-hmm. And who's the designer?
Albert Andrada.
Yes.
What I did was I came into her office and I was prepared. I had a folder with me full of photos of me wearing blue gowns from the past years.
Is blue your power color?
Yeah. So I come up to her and I'm like, Madame, I just wanna make a suggestion. I don't wanna make you angry or upset or anything, but I think I would feel really confident if I had a blue gown for the pageant.
And this is when you won Miss Philippines already.
Yeah. And we were talking about the gown for Miss Universe. And at first she was like, why are you doing this? Why are you suggesting a color and a designer? Like, I'm supposed to choose for you. And I'm like, but it's okay. I'm just suggesting. I'm not going to do anything behind your back. If that's the gown you want, you know, I'll wear that. But I would really feel confident for the competition if you let me wear blue. Please. Like, and I saved all my brownie points just so I can ask for that favor. I was really obedient and I just obeyed. Like, I just said yes to her all the time.
And then so worked.
It worked. I gained her trust and she said, all right, you can wear the blue gown. Just make sure you win. She actually said that to me.
And then she won.
She actually said that to me and I was like, okay, thank you.
All right, so for the lips, I'm going to take the lip pencil from my collection with MAC. This is called Brick and I'm just gonna line the lips. So next, I'm going to take Patrick Wu from the PatrickStarrr MAC collection. And I've never used this on anyone.
Ah.
So crazy. I'm gonna take it on a precision lip brush and I'm gonna fill her lips in. All right, guys, we're gonna go ahead and change and we'll be right back. All right, everyone, this is the finished look. My beauty, my queen, my Miss Universe. I'm so excited to see you judge tonight. We are giving you a beat face, lashes, contour. I'll highlight the whole nine. Mm-hmm. And I hope you guys enjoyed all those tips and tricks and story time. If you guys want to follow Pia, subscribe to her on all social media. Follow her, double tap, because she is serving face every day,
every day.
And to all my Filipino fans, maraming salamat.
Maraming salamat, guys. Thank you so much also, Patrick, for making me look like a Miss Universe.
I'm so, so honored. Thank you so much for coming. If you guys want to see more videos with us or more beauty queens in the future, then subscribe. And I hope to see you guys in my next video. Bye.